building your personal brand. Part of your work in SEO is not only the technical stuff with on-page and off-page SEO, content marketing, so on and so forth, but really we're wielding the two concepts of forging value and building trust, because that's the way that you're going to build a brand. Now, building a personal brand on the web is no different than brands have been built for eons. Giving out value and building trust in the public. You can easily lose that trust by doing offhanded things. So, as you might already know, you kind of want to stay above board with your tactics and everything that you do. Don't try to deceive people, whether it's Google or just the general public. But building your personal brand should be at the forefront of your work, and it should be also at the forefront of your mind all the time. And you have to ask yourself questions like, is what I'm doing building my personal brand? Or am I doing something that, you know, isn't really forging value or building trust in the public? But building your personal brand is really, really important because there's almost no other way for you to gain real traction on the web, especially today, because things are so competitive. There's so many people out there that are vying for our attention that if we're not building a personal brand and we're not getting out there and trying to do the best that we possibly can, then, you know, somebody else is doing it and stepping in, and, you know, we're losing out because of it. So, you know, we can easily lose the trust of people by doing things that are shady or, you know, not really, really above board. So we have to be really, really careful about it. But let's take a look at what branding really is. And I want to tell you, kind of express how important it is and how you're going to build your personal brand. Because not only is this about SEO, but, you know, this is really about business in general. It's about the business of you, whether it's your website or, you know, it's whether it's you personally. This is really a business of you. So what really is a brand? I mean, we all know popular brands like McDonald's. You know, there's tons of others we can think about, like Amazon, IBM, Apple. There's many, many different brands out there that have gained a lot of notoriety. But what is a brand and what is it going to do for you? On the web, you know, a brand is going to make you much more visible. And that's our goal. Google really, really wants to show SERP listings that, you know, have a lot of trust and forge a lot of value. And Google knows that if people are engaged in your website links, your brand, that it's going to trust you more. So it's kind of, you know, kind of builds upon itself. It's the concept of the rich getting richer and the poor getting poorer. You know, in effect, it's really the successful people getting more successful on Google SERPs, because, you know, that's really what it's looking at. You're building momentum in one direction or another. So creating a personal brand is difficult. You know, it takes time, but it's well worth it, because, you know, in the long run, you really do can, you know, when you have that trust, you know, you really can do a lot of different things. And you can build your business immensely by having the trust in people, because, you know, it's far more difficult to branch out there when nobody knows who you are. And it's a lot easier when you have some sort of trust and you've built a brand to get out there and, you know, make sales, you know, drive traffic, increase revenue, so on and so forth. So Neil Patel did a great guide here about building your brand, and I'm just going to go through kind of briefly. You know, he's somebody that definitely is an authority in the field. And I kind of wanted to go over some of the points that he speaks about so that you briefly understand about building your personal brand and the importance of brand awareness. You know, he talks about building a personal brand vision. And I mean, companies have visions and mission statements, and there's no reason why you shouldn't have a vision and a mission statement. This kind of goes along with, you know, setting goals for yourself. But it's more of a core concept than the goal. I mean, it's more about, you know, what are you all about and what do you want people to think that you're all about on the web. So defining a mission is pretty important. So you want to kind of create your vision, create a mission statement. You know, how do you want people to know you? You know, how do you want them to feel about you? So on and so forth. Of course, defining your target audience, and hopefully you've done that already. So I'm going to kind of pass over that one. Building your online and offline assets. You know, we spoke kind of in depth about that, but, you know, there's only so much that I can teach you guys about the importance of, you know, this value and trust, which I've beaten to like a dead horse. You really have to kind of focus on pushing stuff out there that, you know, has a high value. You know, your website, the architecture, the HTML, the underlying technical coding of the site, and of course the content that you release, infographics, videos, media, so on and so forth, and of course, you know, what you do in the social media world, etc. You want to, you know, create some sort of brand outreach, because it's really, really hard to get exposure, and we all know that. So we have to figure out a game plan to get exposure. You have to think about, you know, what are you going to do to help people find out about you? Is it just going to be SEO? Because if it's just SEO, it's going to take a long time. SEO in and of itself takes an exceedingly long amount of time, unless, you know, you're piggybacking off of some huge authority. So unless you have some incredible skills and you're pushing out viral link bait, building your brand solely through SEO is going to be difficult. That's why you need kind of a multi-pronged approach to brand outreach. So one kind of thing that I wanted to speak about is free press coverage. Now, I'm not talking about PR releases, because we spoke about how PR press releases aren't so good for you. You know, Google doesn't really see those as quality links. Now, what I'm talking about here is to develop some press coverage, and I kind of wanted to talk about some of these because these are really great. How Tim Ferriss went out there and got some press coverage for the 4-hour work week before he even got noticed. And you know, the approach that he took was he looked at the current news landscape just to see what was happening in the world, and he found something that the media was interested in, and he was able to connect it to the content that he created. And that's kind of what you have to do. He went out there and he contacted affiliates of national channels such as ABC, CBS, and NBC, and he made a pitch. And a lot of them turned him down because he was nobody. He had no press coverage. You know, not many people were willing to give him a chance, but one did. And it was because of that one that he was able to piggyback off of, because he spoke clearly and effectively. You know, he was able to use that as a great example for others to have him. But you know, for you, of course, you know, you're not a press agent. You know, you're not a promoter, et cetera, et cetera. But you do have to kind of get out there and do a little bit of work. Now, there is one great website that I want to talk about, and it's called Haro, H-A-R-O. And it's a service that connects, you know, experts such as yourself in your industry with journalists. And this is pretty, pretty important because journalists are always looking for, you know, advice from experts in whatever field, because, you know, they're writing an article about anything, and they're looking to get a quote, they're looking to get feedback, so on and so forth. Sign up for Haro. The basic account is free, and you can see that if you find it useful. But this is a great way to kind of build out your profile and to get some, pique some interest from journalists and media people, and potentially get yourself exposed in front of a lot of people. So, you know, this is building your brand. Of course, you have to do a lot of different things to come across as, you know, professional, authoritative, you know, in your field. You're going to want to respond quickly to queries when they come in, so on and so forth. So that's really, really important. You know, you want to get kind of noticed. And there's also Profnet by PR Newswire. And but to sign up to Profnet, you have to contact them. And you know, once you do, you know, you potentially can also get in front of other journalists. It's another great resource to do that. But you know, what you have to do is kind of build your stories. You know, what's your story? You know, what pitch or what angle do you have? You know, as an SEO, you have to be a writer. You have to actually be all things. So, you know, come out with a few stories, you know, build out your stories. Like, what is it about you? Like, what type of attention are you looking for? You know, what angle can you pitch that makes you interesting or a little bit exciting? You know, so you have to kind of go through and do the work. And, you know, it's not a simple effort, but it pays off enormously. Timothy Ferriss was able to get the press coverage by informing people that he was taking an opposite view of the mainstream. And it was because of that opposite view that he got in front of the audience, and he was able to talk intelligibly, and things went off from there, of course. But there's tons of other different things that you can do to build your personal brand, but it's definitely something that you should focus on early on. Aside from having all the fundamentals in place, like a nicely designed website, a good user experience, excellent content, so on and so forth, you should try to connect with some mentors. Try to get out there and find people who are already succeeding in your industry, and try to connect with them and ask for help, and you'll be surprised on the response that you'd get back from people. There's always mentors that are looking to take others under their wing and help them out, so it's definitely not something bad. You can give it a shot, and just reach out to people, and you'll be surprised. I mean, you can use Twitter, you can use LinkedIn, so on and so forth. As you build your brand, you have to monitor it. How's it going? Are things working out effectively for you? How many people did you reach out to this week? How many people responded back? How successful were you? And just be yourself, because there's no need in being somebody else. You are you, and that's great, and there's nothing wrong with it. And you should present that to people, and don't be afraid to speak your mind. And keep in mind also that building your personal brand is going to take time. It's not going to happen overnight. But just keep those core concepts in mind of forging value and building trust, and over time you'll build an awesome brand.